The Industrial Revolution was bringing profound social changes to France. Paris itself was transformed by Baron Haussmann, the prefect of Paris, whose great boulevards were crashing through the old neighborhoods. An elegant, impersonal, modern city was created. New classes emerged and asserted their right to enjoy themselves.
Taking their cue from Manet, younger artists began to paint aspects of modern city life.
But the city they observed was often an uncertain, anonymous place. It offered alienation as well as adventure. The cafe concerts were places of popular entertainment where people from different classes could mingle and their identities could be masked.
Edgar Degas, in particular, explored places like these with an extraordinary variety of techniques, increasingly using pastel as a means of combining colour with drawing.
Je suis heureuse, ma chère, j'en perds la tête. Ah, ce n'est pas de l'amour pour plaisanter. Du beau Raoul, j'ai su faire la conquête. Je suis aimée et je peux m'en vanter. Cet amant-là m'a déjà fait connaître le désespoir, les pleurs, etc. Il voulait même me jeter par la fenêtre. Ah, quel plaisir quand on vous aime comme ça.
In the way he arranged his compositions, Degas looked to the example of the Japanese colour print, whose customary viewpoints and cut-off compositions suggested ways of presenting his vision of the modern world.
À son désir, souvent, je me dérobe, car pour m'aimer, je sais que cet être-là va me déchirer mon jupon et ma robe. Ah, que plaisir, quand on vous aime comme ça. Quand on vous aime, quand on vous aime, quand on vous aime comme ça. Quand tu veux bien m'emmener à la promenade, selon des chemins couverts et poussiérés. Si parce que quand Raoul devient mon seul, il faut tout de suite, que je baisse les yeux.
Pierre-Auguste Renoir painted a far more involved and festive vision of the era. The forms of the figures are dissolved into a play of patches of warm and cool colour, which suggest the fall of sunlight through the trees. By this focus on the surface of appearances, Renoir treats the modern world as a spectacle, rather than creating the sort of moral narrative favoured by academic artists. Of this study, Nude in Sunlight, a newspaper critic said, "Would someone kindly explain to Monsieur Renoir that a woman's torso is not a mass of decomposing flesh with the green and purplish blotches that indicate a state of complete putrefaction in a corpse?" His La Loge was shown at the first Impressionist exhibition in 1874. This exhibition was an explicit rejection of the Salon because it was jury-free. All subscribers had a right to display their work. The show was dominated by outdoor scenes, mostly small, informal pictures which the artists painted in the open air in front of their subjects. Most critics welcomed the initiative of the exhibition, but many also complained that the works were unfinished, with their visible brushwork and their imprecise definition of form. The artists themselves distinguished between their more elaborate and tidily executed canvases and their sketches, rapid notations of subjects or natural effects. One of Claude Monet's sketches, Impression Sunrise, precipitated the naming of the group as Impressionists. The expatriate American James McNeill Whistler was also invited to join the first exhibition, but he preferred to continue showing his work in London, although his very simple, freely brushed nocturnes had much in common with the Impressionists' atmospheric sketches. It was this lack of finish which led the celebrated English critic Ruskin to accuse Whistler of flinging a pot of paint in the face of the public. The Impressionists' interest in open-air painting led them to the landscape on the outskirts of Paris and the expanding villages along the River Seine. Such areas were meeting places of several different worlds. Camille Pissarro made art out of the least prepossessing parts of his surroundings. Even a drab road in Louveciennes, where he lived, could provide the raw material for art. Pissarro generally peopled the streets of Louveciennes with peasant figures, showing it as a country village. But when Renoir painted the same stretch of road, he transformed it into a cheerful pleasure ground with fashionably dressed strollers from the city. Monet lived for 5 years at Argenteuil on the River Seine. He painted it over and over again in all weathers and all seasons. He was becoming increasingly concerned with the problems of translating fleeting light effects into paint. But he continued to explore the many different facets of the place. Industry itself, the cause of suburban expansion, was largely ignored or evaded, although the chimneys of a local factory made a discreet appearance.
But all these landscapes show his surroundings very much in a process of change, of transformation. And this went right against the conventions of contemporary French landscape painting, which presented the countryside of France as a sort of timeless, historical world.